Hi guys, today I'm going to be doing a get ready with me video. This is my first ever get ready with me, so I'm so excited to be doing this. If you like this look, then continue watching my video because I will show you how I got this. It's a more casual, relaxed video, so I'll be literally kind of chatting with you and showing you what I do to my face. But before we continue to the next section, I do want to quickly ask you to subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, you want to see more of my videos where I talk about beauty and fashion and whatnot. So do subscribe to my channel before you leave, and if you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. And without further ado, let's jump into the next section. Just a heads up though, I don't have any makeup on in the next section of the video, so don't get scared. So I'm gonna be using my favorite foundation. It is the Maybelline Matte and Poreless Fit Me foundation. I have two colors that I need to mix because you can probably tell that my face is a lot lighter than the rest of my body, my neck mainly, and that's because I do fake tan, but I don't typically apply fake tan on my face only because I've got acne and dry spots on my face. Fake tan doesn't really like dry spots, doesn't like acne, so it just ends up going on really weird, and I wear makeup on top of my face anyway, so I can just kind of create my own version of fake tan with the right foundation color, which is going to have to be a mix of these two. So I have 332 and then 128, so I'll just mix that on the back of my hand. So I'm just going to be using a beauty blender that's very much so it needs to be washed and cleaned and like seriously deep conditioned, de-stained, whatever you want to call it. But I'm still trying to figure out how to do it because I've literally tried oil, I've tried baby shampoo, I've tried Dawn dish liquid soap, regular soap liquid, and bar of soap, and nothing seems to actually get rid of every single stain. Like, they do clean the beauty blender and I can see a bunch of like foundation come off and stuff, and it feels a lot cleaner afterwards, but you can still see the stain. And wow, that was a good color match. Hello. It's little things in life that make you feel really good about yourself. Like, matching your foundation to your neck color is one of those things that just, it's gonna make you feel so good. Okay, so I think we're good on the foundation front. For my under eye concealing, this is the Maybelline Master Conceal, and it's amazing. It just looks so good, and you can really get a more natural look with it as opposed to something that just looks kind of more caked on. So I'm just gonna blend that out with my beauty blender. So you can tell, I mean, it gets rid of the dark circles really easily. You don't need too much of it either. It spreads really nicely, and I love, love, love it. Oh, I guess I'm gonna conceal that little area. All right, now it's time for some powder. I'll be using my trusty Laura Mercier powder. It's expensive as all heck, but I love it. And I'm gonna be using my Dampen Beauty Blender. I like to kind of bake my face, but kind of not. So I do my own version of baking my face because I don't really need to bake my face necessarily right now. But I'm not really baking my face. As you can see, I don't have like a lot of powder on my skin right now. So I'm doing a very light baking. I mainly do this underneath my eyes because I don't get acne like underneath my eyes because there's no oil glands there. I don't feel scared to do it there because obviously if you have a lot of powder and concealer and this and that on your skin, your pores are gonna be blocked. And if you have acne prone skin, good luck to you basically. And so I'm just trying to be a little bit conscious of that and making sure that, you know, I don't cake up my face. My powder brush is actually quite dirty at the moment. So I'm gonna have to improvise a little bit and use a different brush, which I typically would use for bronzer. This is an old brush that my mom gave to me when I was in high school, I think, like part of my first-ish brush set. And this is from Lancome. So this was like my baby for the longest time because, you know, this is a fancy Lancome brush. When I was in high school, you know, I didn't have anything that fancy. I still don't actually have anything that fancy now that I think about it. Anyway, let me just go ahead and apply powder everywhere else. So I'll be using a palette which I haven't used in a while, but I figured since I'm doing this, I might as well bust it out and start using it. This is the Smashbox Contouring Powder set, and I did a review on this a little while ago. Back in my, when I didn't have my nicer camera and I have really, really dark hair. So it's a totally like new experience of Yana if you watch that video. This has three different colors and I'll be using my trusty Real Techniques blush brush. I don't use this for blush. I use this for contouring mainly. So I'm just gonna go ahead and apply the darker of the two colors, the cooler color. Just start building that in. I'm using the very tip of this brush because I really want to only add that darkest kind of cooler color where I truly want the contouring line to be, and then I'm going to soften that out with the warmer color, and I'm going to use kind of the slope of the brush to do that, and that's where I'm going to kind of make it a little bit more natural looking and not just have that line going. Okay, now I'm going to go in with the warmer color. I also like to kind of bring it into the hairline because I have a very pale hair part right here, and obviously if your hair part is really, really pale and your skin is like really dark here, it doesn't look really natural. Now I know in reality you can have your hair part in one way and then you tan and then you flip your hair and that part of your scalp doesn't have any color to it. So it could actually happen in real life without using fake tan, but it always looks kind of unnatural. So I just prefer to, obviously I'm not really putting a lot of color in there, but just kind of dabbing the color in a little bit just so it kind of fades out more, if you know what I mean. And I'm gonna start to contour my nose a little bit. This is a very light contouring that's gonna happen right now. I just literally draw a straight line down. My nose is not ideal for contouring because I do have this bump here. If I didn't have the bump, it would look even better. If you have a straighter nose, you're gonna be in a much better shape than I am. I like my nose. I'm not saying anything like terribly bad about it, but I just mean for this purpose, it's probably not ideal. But you know what? My nose works. It smells things, and that's kind of the main purpose of a nose. So I also bring the contouring kind of into the eye socket. That just looks nice. Alright, let's go ahead and add some blush. And this is the Body Shop's color number 9. It's really, really old. As you can see, it's well loved and pretty much all gone. But it's just a very natural, it's kind of like a contoury color, but it has more red in it, so it becomes a blush color. I would wear this if I want to have blush on my cheeks, but almost seem like I don't, if you know what I mean, because it's so close to the contour color, but it just has a little bit of extra color in it, which I think is very, very good, especially because I am going to be doing a red lip. Well, I think we're done with the face, so let's go ahead and do the eyes. I'm going to apply a little bit of eyeshadow primer. A must do for somebody who has oily eyelids. This is Too Faced Shadow Insurance. Then I'm going to go ahead and start applying a little bit of eyeshadow. I'm not going to do too much, but I'm going to go ahead and use the Naked 2 palette. Yeah, I think I'll go for two colors. One is going to be called YDK and the other one's going to be Busted. I don't know what that means, but I'm going for it. YDK is going to go on my eyelid. Just packing the color on. I'm also going to use the edge of this brush to apply the color underneath the eye as well. I like to tap off the excess because